I'm going to do off the ground.
Two more beers tonight for money with that second bonus point try. How excited are you guys as a team going into these last two games? I mean, I know, and yeah, I don't know if you look at the presentations yet, but how excited are you for these last two games?
Still alive. To start off, still alive. We know it's probably going to be up to us, looking at the other results as well. You don't want to drop the ball, reading too much on the other results. We know probably needed about 11 points out of the last three games. So yes, there's a lot of work and there's a lot of stuff to be fixed, but that's 5 points and we're alive, we're breathing.
That quick tap, the Q's shot, was that something from the video sessions or was that a read on the field?
No, I think that was just Q and IDing space, and I know he's got pace, so we looked up and we saw the space and I backed him. So yeah, I think it's basically being on the same page and reacting quickly, and we actually didn't plan for going quick taps. I know we obviously scored off it as well in the first half, but it's something we have in our arsenal, and once we can use it, I think we did it well. So yeah.
Going into the second half, you wouldn't have been too happy with just with the tempo change. A lot of tempo in the beginning, in the second half it seemed just a bit more muted. Is it more of a Cardiff response to you guys, or do you feel like maybe the guys just sort of would find it difficult to get into the second half?
I think it's probably a little bit of accuracy from our side, whether it was set piece or first breakdown, first job. Whether it was, like I said, not us really being that clinical. First up, allowed them either turnover or penalty against us, and then to really build tempo and build pressures, then it's actually impossible in that moment. So then you jog back 30, 40 meters back, and now you're defending set piece again. So it's probably not really accurate enough from our side, especially the first 15, 20 minutes after half time.
Cash, baie geluk met die wen in die eerste plek, maar mens voel bietjie asof in die eerste helfte na die vinnige 2-3 wat ons gedruk het, toe slaan ons oor waar ons strafskoppe kry, gaan ons pale toe in steede van kant toe, en dis goed as mens die ander span seker respek gee, maar ek dink julle nie dit het dalk bietjie selfvertroue vir Cardiff gegee om weer terug te kom in die wedstryd?
Ek dink nie noodwendig selfvertroue nie. Ek dink as ons meer akkuraat was rondom eerste fase of tweede fase, was dit dalk heeltemal anders geweest. Daar was 'n slag of twee waar ons gevoel het ons kon dalk 'n bietjie meer van 'n risiko geneem het, of soos die Engelsman sê, myself 'n backer toe gegaan het. Maar soos ek sê, as jy dan nie daar akkuraat is nie, kan dit ook 'n vorm van frustrasie wees. So ek dink aan die algemeen net 'n bietjie meer akkuraat van ons kant af, en dit kon een helemaal ander resultaat geweest het. En nog steeds gelukkig met die 5 punte, maar ek denk dat ons kon al definitief meer klinisch geweest het.
Daar was definitief een hele paar kere waar ons kon 3 gaan druk het, maar die beweging het doodgeloop. Daar was definitief meer 3 op die veld geweest.
Ja, ek denk ons het, vooral in die laatste, as jy nou die laatste 10 minute kyk, was daar seker nog 2 of 3 geleenthede wat ons wat skep het. Die ene het bal in die hand gegaan nie, die ander ene was geblaas as obstruksie. Ek dink dit was ook goeie lyn geweest, so definitief net die laatste 10 minute se 2 of 3 geleenthede. Ek dink in die wedstryd was daar nog 'n hele paar geweest wat ons kon gebruik het.
Marius, hy het nou al daai vraag gevra, maar ek wil ook vra daai tikskoppie wat jy in die veld, in die spasie ingeskop het vir Rooyen wat gaan druk het. Is dit iets wat julle ooit voorheen bespreek het, of was dit nou heeltemal op die ingewing van die oomblik gewees vandag?
Ja, ek dink, soos ek sê, Q&A het gesê, daar is spasie en ons maak seker ons kom so vinnig as moeilik by die bal om te kyk wat die opsies is, en hy het gesien daar's spasie in die agterkant, en toe ek links kyk was daar net voories gewees, so ek het geweet hy sal hulle kan brand en vir die 3 kan gaan, so ek het net seker gemaak skop dit in spasie in.
Okay, mens kyk nou vorentoe na die Glasgow wedstryd wat nou volgende Saterdag gebeur. Die span sal definitief hulle vertoning 'n bietjie moet lig om daai een te wen.
Ek dink baie algemeen die spelers sal dieselfde voel. Ek dink ons kon meer klinies wees. Ek dink ons skep kanse deur eerste 2-3 fases nog meer klinies te wees. Dink ek ons kan regtig konstant druk op die posisie sit. Ons sal teen 'n bietjie ons vaste fasiteit ook op opskerp. So ons is onder geen illusie dat ons het vandag gesien wat Laskou ten die bille kan doen. Hoe hulle teruggekom het. Trotse span, doelpie punte deur vir die URC. Ons weet dit gaan 'n goeie effort vir ons kant af vat, maar soos ek sê, ons is lewendig en dit gee ons kans en dit gee ons hoop.
En dit klink of dit Willem Albert se laaste wedstryd was vandag. Ek's nou nie 100% seker nie. Dit klink, ek hoor maar so tussen die lyne, maar hoe spesiaal was dit om so 'n speler te hê by die Leeu die laaste paar jaar?
Dit is definitief sy laaste wedstryd op sy verjaarsdag, maar ek dink dit is sy laaste wedstryd. So vir ons, en ek het van dit sy boodskap vandag wat ek vir hom gestuur het gesê, eers dankie vir wat hy in die span doen, dankie vir wat hy beteken. Ek dink die mense sien net so 10% op sosiale media van wat hy eintlik is en wat die span beteken. As jy binne ons sy spel vandag kyk, is moeilik om te glo die ou is 40. Beweeg rond, vat leiding, lekker visie, so nee, dis absolute plesier om ons span te hê en so voorreg.
That first half, just watching you guys on the field, it was physical, it was you guys were under defensive pressure, you guys were standing up. High fives. How fun is that for you guys? I mean, how enjoyable was that? Was that the sense of the team at that point?
Yeah, you know, I think we obviously pride ourselves on our attack, but we get alive in our defense. You know, we make sure that we get up front, get off the line, and make sure we get good hits, and we stay in our system. And when we do that, we get turnoverable, and that's when our back three are so dangerous. So we make sure that we defend well so that we are able to score off it as well.
Coach, last question. Coach, just on that back three, I mean, you've got playmakers all over the show. How blessed are you to feel? I mean, when you have such players, we can sort of run it from anywhere. I mean, you had a great kick from your winger, Jordan, you know, to be touch. I mean, how nice is that to how much of a luxury is that for you?
Yeah, it's definitely. We're definitely blessed in that aspect, having players with X factor, having players with speed, having players with playmaking ability. That you can play multiple positions, whatever we feel the need is. So the 6-2, we were nervous for losing a winger, and unfortunately that happened early, but luckily we did speak about it. And the nice thing about like the players you mentioned is whether they play 11, 14, 15, 13, 12, 10, not sure Mara will start into 9 that comfortably, but the rest is nice for us. So the more, and it, sometimes it's hard for players when you say, listen, we want you to be versatile, but we see it as a massive benefit.
Injury update?
Not quite sure. Obviously Richard came off early with what seems to be a bit of a hamstring needle, but hopefully we pull him off early enough.
That's nice. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.